In this presentation, we'll have a look at the different types of data that can be called primary biodiversity data and shared within JBIF. These data can be complex and have different origins. We'll see how they can be structured into one of the three data classes accepted by JBIF based on the Darwin Core data sharing standard that is used within the JBIF community. As you can see on this slide, JBIF currently supports four types of datasets. Resource datasets, or metadata-only datasets, species checklists, occurrence datasets, and sampling event datasets. I will not discuss resource datasets in this presentation, as metadata-only datasets are not supported by the JBIF-funded programs. The first type of dataset that can be published within JBIF is the checklist, aka a list of species or higher taxa. In a checklist, the main unit is the taxon, not the occurrence or individual. Checklists and more generally taxonomical datasets can vary in scope. A list of species present in a protected area is a checklist. A national or thematic list of taxa, for example butterflies of Laos or the flora of Malaysia, which sometimes provide more information on the distribution, taxonomical hierarchy, and synonyms of the taxa, is a checklist. IUCN red lists at the international, national, or regional levels also are checklists and can give more information about the vulnerability status of the listed taxa. JBIF provides data publishers with templates for each class of dataset. The JBIF template for checklists, taxon data, allows you to share information linked to each species or taxa. Its ID, full name and authorship, relationship to other taxa, geographical details, and so on. In this template, one line represents one taxon, and the taxon can only appear once in the dataset. Otherwise, it will create a duplicate. The second type of data that can be published within JBIF is data coming from natural history or scientific collections, also known as specimens. Unlike checklists, the main unit in a specimen collection will be the specimen, a single organism or group of organisms. And you can have multiple specimens from the same species or taxon group. Collections and specimens vastly differ in numbers, size, and preservation methods. However, any kind of collection that holds preserved living organisms can be captured and shared within JBIF. Herbarium or zoological collections, including fossils, for example, but geology or human artifacts collections do not fall under the JBIF scope. Biodiversity data can also be found in technical and scientific literature. It is possible to compile and share this kind of data within JBIF, but you should be extra cautious not to share duplicate data. For example, a specimen described in a scientific article might already be present on jbiff.org in the dataset of its collection. In the absence of digitized datasets, biodiversity data can be extracted and compiled from scientific articles, PhD or master theses, reports, and other documents. Please note that you should always contact the data owner first when compiling literature data to ask for permission to publish them to JBIF. A large majority of the data available on jbiff.org now comes from fieldwork records. This data can be observed and/or collected using different protocols in the field by scientists, naturalists, or amateur citizen scientists via programs and apps. This field data can be compiled in survey reports, environmental impact assessment studies, field notes, and other logs. They can be linked to other types of data, such as checklists, which are complementary to occurrence data observed or collected in the wilderness. Occurrence data represents the JBIF class of datasets with the largest number of records on jbiff.org. Collection, aka specimens, literature, and fieldwork data can be shared within JBIF using this template, which focuses on the observed individual or collected specimen. In this kind of dataset, multiple individuals or specimens can be recorded for a single taxon, as long as they each have a unique identifier. Other fields for occurrence data include where, when, how, and by whom was each occurrence observed and or collected in the field. Event data is a class of datasets that was added on JBIB.org in 2015. They allow data publishers to share more information about the context of the observation or collection of specimens and to group occurrences linked to the same event. The JBIF template for event data allows data publishers to share more information about the context of a biodiversity data collecting or recording event, such as camera traps, insect traps, botanical relevés, birding sites, and so on. Its structure is a bit more complex than the taxonomical datasets and occurrence datasets, as it involves two files, namely two tabs in a spreadsheet, one for describing the events, or for example each trap, and the other one to describe the specimens or occurrences linked to each event. Sometimes, additional information or data can be found using other source materials than those previously mentioned in this video. These other sources include remote sensing tools, maps and satellite data, and other information supports such as pictures, audio and video recordings of wildlife. Most of the time, the information retrieved this way is supplemental to existing data, but can provide valuable information about individuals and their location, habitat, migratory routes, and so on. In the following slides, we will see how the Darwin Core standard works with different types of data and how to choose the dataset class that best fits a given dataset. As you learned in the Foundation's Darwin Core presentation, Darwin Core is a data sharing standard developed by the Biodiversity Information Standards Organization, or TDWG, and is widely used to publish data within the extended JBIF community. Depending on the type of dataset with which you work, you'll have to choose one of its three cores, occurrence, taxon, or event core, which can be linked to one or more extensions to share more information, such as multimedia links, variables, identification history, and so on. In some cases, a core can be used as an extension linked to another core. That is the case when publishing event data, where one can use the event core to describe the sampled areas, and then use the occurrence core as an extension to share the specimens or individuals recorded. Once the data has been standardized using the Darwin Core standard, each class of dataset, metadata only, sampling event, taxonomic or occurrence datasets, can be published on JBIF.org using one of the tools mentioned on this figure. The most frequently used tool within the JBIF community is the JBIF Developed Integrated Publishing Toolkit, or IPT, which transforms the source data into Darwin Core archives that are then harvested and indexed by JBIF. The data are then searchable and downloadable by JBIF.org. Choosing a dataset class can take some time, especially if you're new to data publishing within JBIF. The JBIF Help Desk team created this useful flowchart, which can be found on the JBIF data blog. If your data are not yet captured in the database or spreadsheet, or if they are too incomplete to be shared yet, you can publish a description of your data as a metadata-only dataset. Please note this option is not allowed in the context of the BID and BIFA programs. If your dataset contains a list of scientific names that are not referring to observed and/or collected organisms or specimens, you can publish it as a taxonomical resource or checklist. If your dataset includes scientific names linked to observed and/or collected specimens, as well as dates and locations, you can share it as an occurrence dataset. Lastly, if information about the protocols used on the field are available, you can choose to share the dataset as a sampling event dataset. Each class of dataset shared within JBIF has to meet its own data quality requirements. Some requirements are mandatory, such as the occurrence ID, taxon ID, or event ID, depending on the type of dataset. Others are optional but strongly recommended, such as coordinates in decimal degrees. You can find these requirements on jbiff.org from the How-To menu. In order to be able to publish data to JBIF, it is important to understand the differences between the dataset classes at the early stage of the data capture and data managing process. You can reflect on this topic with the following questions. Is your data type different than you originally thought? With what kind of data do you work? How would you publish them to JBIF? Using which crawl and/or extension? If you have questions on this presentation, please use the provided forum in the e-learning platform. This video is part of a series of presentations used in the JBIF Biodiversity Data Mobilization course. The Biodiversity Data Mobilization curriculum was originally developed as part of the Biodiversity Information Development Programme funded by the European Union. This presentation was originally created and narrated by Sophie Pamerlan, with additional contributions by BID and BIFA trainers, mentors, and students.